We drive you from us, whoever you may be. Unclean spirits, all satanic powers, all infernal invaders, all wicked legions, assemblies, and sects. In the name and by the power of our Lord Jesus Christ, may you be snatched away and driven from the Church of God, from the souls made to the image and likeness of God and redeemed by the precious blood of your Lamb. And it's a form of a prayer, so that we don't get overly excited with the word because of TV and movies and stuff. So it's a form of a prayer, like you have prayers of thanksgiving, of praise, of petition, and then you have exorcism. And it's in two branches. One has to do with deliverance. So it's someone seems to think that they need to be delivered from something evil. So they would take that left hand, say, and then but there's a manifestation directly in front of you of something evil, then you would address that manifestation. But sometimes it's a little bit more, spectacular, like if someone just seems to be talking from another world, they're saying obscenities, and then they want to kill me, you know. I want to kill you, that type of thing. Then that's kind of a little bit, you say, well, hold it. If this person is just sick or just losing their, you know, going into a deep depression of some kind, and, you know, like the guy did say that killed somebody on the bus, you know, what was that? I don't want to get involved in where a sickness takes over a person and they're going to get, you know, or slap me in the face or cut my throat. So I got to take some precautions.
Yeah, like it's a very common type of experience for people with schizophrenia because you're having hallucinations, and these hallucinations might be saying that you're damned or that there's something bad about you, that you haven't been a good enough person. And so, you know, a lot of people in their soul searching to try and figure this out, you know, come to the conclusion that this must be a failure of my faith.
But on a historical level, this is also being reinforced by other kinds of trends. You know, the model of health and wealth and happiness that we have, and that you just need to get rid of all the bad things or overcome the bad things and you know, keep your, you know, spiritual household, you know, cleansed. These things all are sort of coming together right now to create a kind of hotbed and interest in ghosts and spirits. And along with that comes a particular kind of emphasis on exorcisms.
The power of Christ compels you! The power of Christ compels you!
Il messaggero non è importante.
Well, from the movie Exorcism, there's a lot of components that are happen, but they're all put together in one case. So, like, it's difficult to appreciate the reality of that, exactly what it's all about. You don't want to dismiss the fact that because if there's an exaggeration, because it's a movie, that these exorcisms don't happen, or these entities don't have a grab on some hold of on some people. So you have to be open to that at all the time. We have to remember those cases we read about in, you know, these flashy cases, that they're very rare, and then that doesn't mean they're not real.
And so you can see how it would be very ripe set of circumstances for someone to maybe turn to their faith or to their religion to say that this is a manifestation of maybe having not been a good enough Christian or having not prayed well enough, or and religion in the reverse order also can say, well, maybe that's what you need to do more of. You need to demonstrate more faith. And so while well-meaning, you know, that can have some potential negative and synergistic consequences where the person does then say, well, yes, this is because of a failure of my faith. And I believe that because that's what I'm being told by my religious leaders.
And of course, because sort of theories of demonic possession, because of the way they work, you might be repossessed at any time, right? So you might need to go another exorcism. Maybe you didn't really get at the root cause. You just had the root cause of your possession, but now we really need to get deeper into it. So you might have to do more spiritual mapping or more spiritual cleansing or another kind of ritual, or sort of modify the ritual in another way. So this can be a lifelong struggle. And again, I'm casting this in, you know, therapeutic language, because most exorcism today adopts therapeutic language. You know, when people are talking about Christ and the Holy Spirit, part of exorcism, if you delete those words, you know, what people are saying mostly resonates with what Oprah Winfrey says. I mean, the same kind of language of the therapeutic language.
First time it happened for me, it was the first time that someone would be lifted up from the floor. But when I went there, it was basically sent to discern to see what kind of help could be done for those people. And when I arrived there, I had a hard time to find the place, but I met someone down in the streets. They kind of knew that I was, you know, going to that place. They led me right there where they themselves lived, upstairs, last floor. And then when I tried to find out what seems to be the problem, they were kind of obsessed with the idea they needed an exorcism. I said, well, you know, I don't do an exorcism because you ask it. Like, I mean, if somebody says, take my tonsils out, well, I want to make sure that it's the right thing to do. So I says, usually when I come and I don't know what's happening on, I usually bless, I have a prayer of blessing the area, the rooms and stuff like that. So I had to convince them that it was okay for me to do that. So I said prayers in the rooms and I started at the doors and I walked around in the living room and then a couple of bedrooms, sitting room, smoke room, whatever. And I came finished in the kitchen, small kitchen. There was a table there that takes the whole room of the kitchen. And the lady who seemed to have the problem was on my right-hand side. She was standing in front of the fridge. Nothing had happened when I blessed her. I didn't feel anything. So I had my final prayer. And when I was saying the final prayer, she lifted up off the floor. And then she kind of went horizontal and slammed on the floor. Then I knew that was something that's totally out of the ordinary. So then I pulled out my ritual and I had a ritual prayer. And that seemed to have done an effect that never happened again. It's like the first time that I've seen someone kind of, it wasn't, you know, gravity didn't seem to mean too much there. Some of the priests don't want to get involved in that at all. And some of them don't believe in that, you know. So, I mean, but I know it's not a matter of me believing in it or not. It's just fact. You know, I don't have to believe that the sun is up there. It's a fact. For me, these things are fact.